Hello everybody, welcome back to another Blender Made Easy video. Today I'm going to be showing you how to use a pen on a graphics tablet in Blender. There is multiple ways to use it, but I think the most common one is sculpting. Alright, and so what I did with my pen, I did the first button is the middle mouse, and the second button is right click. So if I hold down the first button and I go across, it moves the view like that, and I think that's really cool. Because let's say you're sculpting or doing some sort of work, it would be such a pain to go all the way over to your mouse and then move the view and then go back to your pen and then draw. So what I did, let me just go back over here. What I did is I set the keybind like I just said, and so if I hold it, I can pan the view and then work over here, whatever, then go back over here and then go like that. I think that's really, really cool. And the graphics tablet that I got is called, let me grab the box real quick. It is called Huen 420. Huen 420. I think I'm saying that right. It's Huen, whatever. I'll link it in the description so you guys can go check it out. Another really common way to use the graphics tablet is by using the grease pencil. So let's open up the toolbar, come over here to the grease pencil in the tab right there and click draw. And what's really cool is the harder you press on the tablet, the thicker the line will become. I'll show you in a second. So if we, let's come over, where did it go? Right there. If I go really light at first, and then I come thicker, and then I go light again, as you can see, let's zoom in a little bit. It goes like that. The harder I pressed on the tablet, the thicker the grease pencil line became. I think that's really cool. And I've also heard people like using the grease pencil to create animations. I have no idea how to do that. That seems just really crazy to me. But I think this could help if one of you watching does that. So like that. Oh, no, wait, I have to click draw again. Draw. And let me come like this. Like that. Yeah. Like that. And there's multiple things that you could do. These are, I think, are just the main ones, sculpting and the grease pencil. I think you could do a little bit of modeling, but it would be really hard. Let's just try something. Let's go into edit mode, and if I press G, and I'm my hand is on the keyboard and my other hand is holding the pen, so I'm gonna try this. G, Z. So you can move stuff around, and then if I right click, oh gosh, what happened? Wait, right click, there we go, then it'll snap back to the middle. Alright, and then let's just try coming down here. Oh man, this would not be great. Let's just select multiple faces like that and extrude, and then there we go. Oh man, yeah, so modeling, it's not the best for modeling, but it's still cool. So now I'm gonna jump over into Photoshop and then I'll show you what to do over there. So now we're in Photoshop, and how to enable the graphics tablet is you come over here to this little button, you click this, and then there's a couple of things that you can do. The first one, I'm just gonna uncheck those, the first one is Shape to Dynamics. Make sure the control is set to pen pressure right here. I think it's automatically set to like fade or something. Set it to pen pressure, and then if we come over here, it works the same way as the grease pencil did. The harder I press down, the thicker the line becomes, like that. Let's try that again, because that line was not very good. Like that, and up. There we go. That looks pretty good. So as you can see, that looks decent, but there's still more that you could do. Let's come over to the transfer. This will make it so the lighter you press, the less you'll be able to see it, the opacity, that it controls the opacity. So make sure the control is set to pen pressure, not fade, pen pressure. And then if we just go like this, hold on, and like that. So as you can see, right over here it's really low transparency, and then over here it's really high. You can totally see it. So that's really cool. And then there's some more stuff that you can do, like the dual brush. I think you can I think the color dynamics, maybe. Yeah, you can set it to pen pressure. I'm not sure what this one does yet. I haven't really played around with some of these settings. But most of these, you can use the pen pressure as the control. So that's really cool. The scattering, I know you can, pen pressure right there. And there's a lot of other cool stuff. So that was the graphics tablet, and you don't have to do anything in Blender to enable it. All you have to do is just plug it in and start using it. But in Photoshop, you do have to set it to pen pressure right there. Alright, well, that is going to be it, so thank you for watching. I know it's a short video, but the next tutorial that I'm going to be doing is going to be pretty cool, so watch out for that. It's going to be uploaded in a week or so, not totally sure. So, and also, if you guys have suggestions on tutorials that you would like me to cover, like, let's say, fire or more fluid, whatever you have in mind, leave it down in the comments and I'll be sure to look at it. Alright, that's going to be it. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.